As an automation developer, ChatGPT will become the thing to learn in 2023. Here's how to implement it in Power Automate Desktop. My name is Anders Jensen and I'm from I Love Automation. I've created an empty Power Automate Desktop flow. Before we continue, you should download this little helping document. I placed a link to it in the video description below. The first thing you want to grab, that is this newest endpoint. So go mark it, and again, you can download it in the video description below. Mark it, Control C, navigate to a browser. Paste in the URL, and the URL that we need is this one here. Don't take this URL blindly from the document, it's also there. Always go to this URL here and grab it, whatever that says here. This changes a lot, and that's the reason we always want to go to this page to grab the URL. Back to Power Automate Desktop. Up in Actions, you will find an Invoke web service. This is a REST API call. We use this to call ChatGPT or OpenAI and get a response back. Up here in URL, you just press Control V. This is the endpoint that we want to target. The method that is post, so click the dropdown, choose post. We also want to say this is not XML, so this is a JSON, both the data we send and the data that we receive. Headers, here we put in the authorization, that is to say who we are. So we say authorization. Make sure you spell it like this. Then you have a colon, a space, you'll say bearer, and then another space. Now we need to find our API key. So go down to the document again and mark this API key here. Control C, go to your browser once more. Here you open up a new tab and paste it in. In case you see this, you should either log in or sign up for a new account. It's free, so you can easily just sign up. You will even get $18 free in credit. I have an account, so I click login. Once we logged in, it looked like this. Click create new secret key and copy the key you get. Move back to Power Automate Desktop. So right here, remember the space after bearer, paste in this API key. Then we need a request body. I put in an optimal request body here. So from the curly bracket start and end, make sure you grab everything. I copy it and go back to the request body and paste it in. Let's talk a little bit about what this means. First, we have a model. That is text DaVinci 003. That is another GPT model from OpenAI. It's not ChatGPT directly, but it's very close too. And soon the ChatGPT API will be here and you will set it up just like this. Then we need a prompt. Here we will use a variable. So for now, I'll just say input in these hard brackets. Here we will replace it in a little while. Then we have max tokens. Here it says 1,000. That defines how many tokens ChatGPT should use from your account. 1,000 tokens, that is around 750 words. You have about 900,000 tokens for free, so that is 700,000 words. That's a lot. Then there's the temperature, set to 0, that is randomness in output. It ranges from 0 to 1, where 0 is very low randomness in output. Let me just scroll down here. We also have n equals 1. That is how many completions to generate for each prompt. The higher, the more completions, but you will also consume more tokens. So be careful. I recommend 1. You can also define stop words. That is, if ChatGPT face them, it will stop using more tokens. One important setting is that you go to advanced here, under encode, request body, untick it. Then scroll all the way down. The variable that we want to look at specifically, that is the web service response. Here, our response from ChatGPT will be in. So I click save. Before this Invoke web service, we will just have a display input dialog here, and I'll drag it in front of the Invoke web service. The title that will be ChatGPT. The input dialog message here, I can say ask ChatGPT about something. Here we have two variables produced. Let me open it. We have a button pressed and a user input. We could lock the button press, say, for example, the user will click cancel, but I prefer not to for this simple example. Then we save our user input in a variable called user input. We will use this variable down here in the body, so I'll reopen the Invoke web service. And in here, make sure you delete this input with the hard brackets. We're still in the two quotation marks. I click this X here, double click the user input. Now you can see we used it here. Then we click save. Now we can run it. So here I can say, give me a travel guide to Copenhagen, max 3 lines. I'll click OK. We will call the ChatGPT. And if you go over here to web service response, double click over here. This is the JSON that we get back. Here you can see that under we have this JSON. If I go inside this choices here, you can see that this is an array, by the way, with these hard brackets. Then I move into text where it says, visit the iconic little mermaid statue and take a stroll along the Nyhavn waterfront, explore the colorful streets of the Latin Quarter, and blah, blah, blah. So the connection works. Now we can pass this text out of it because there's a lot of things that we don't really want. We don't want the ID and all this stuff. So what I do here is that I click close. We want to take out this text from the JSON, and we do that by converting the JSON to an object, and then we can easily call it. Let me show you. So I go up here to actions. Here I'll say convert JSON to custom object, and I drag it in here. So my JSON, that is the web service response that we get out here. So I simply just do this, web service response. The variables produced, that is JSON as custom object, that's fine, I click save. Now to display the message, I'll just have a display message, but it could be your system, an email system, whatever you wanted. We just do it simple here, so I have a display message. Down here in the message to display, I want to look into the JSON as custom object. So I do this. And then I go inside these percentage sign. I want to say, go into choices. So I have a hard bracket, single quotation marks. Then I say choices like this. Then I want a single quotation mark, hard bracket end. I want the first element. This was an array. We only had one item in this array, but still, we still need to call it. Since this is zero indexed, that is, the first element is zero. If we had two elements, then the second element would be one. And then I want to move into the text. I can say dot text. Again, I will disable the button press to not confuse ourselves. I'll click save. Now I'll click run. Here I will say why should I engage in a community as an RPA developer? Then I click OK. We will make the REST API call. And here you can see engaging in a community as an RPA developer is beneficial for a number of reasons. And that's where I want to end. If you want to join more than 6,000 automation developers, you should look at the I Love Automation Discord community. Here we network and help each other with solutions. See you there.